start. Hurry, come, hurry. Oh yeah. Time for Bible school again tonight. I'm so excited. Concrete and cranes, getting our foundation built strong and firm. Strong and firm. The verse, got it. I don't have the verse. Do you guys have the verse? Miss Jackie don't have it memorized either. Okay, so we're going to start our Bible school out like we do every week. Every night during the week, we're going to start out with our pledges. Pledge to our American flag. I pledge to our Christian flag, pledge to the Bible, and open in prayer. Okay, everybody, just take that time. Thank you.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one Savior, crucified, buried, risen, and coming again with life and liberty for all who believe.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide his word in my heart that I might not sin against God.
Okay, Mr. Charlie, if you'll pray for our Bible school for tonight.
Lord, the most kind and Father, Lord, we thank thee for the privilege once again that you've allowed us to come and call upon your precious name. Lord, we just come thank you for the blessings of this walk of life. I want to thank you most of all, though, for your son Jesus who went to Calvary, shed his blood, and through his blood we could have life and have it everlasting. Lord, for a Bible school, Lord, I just pray, Lord, that you take and use the teachers there, Lord. Lord, and then give the children receptive hearts to receive your word. Lord, as this Bible school ends at the end of it, Lord, may we have great reports, Lord, that God moved in heart. Lord, people come to accept you as their Savior. Lord, just be with each one that each night, Lord, in the Bible school. Lord, have your sweet way in everything that's done. We'll give thee the honor and the praise and the glory. And ask you in the dear Son, Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Okay. We're ready for a Bible lesson. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Ready to see what's going on with Sandy Not So Wise and Roxy the Wise from our investigative reporter.
Miss Izzy.
Where is she? But she's out on that job site. Wonder who we're going to see, who she's going to meet up with today.
Let's see. Oh, man, I forgot.
Paul. I think it's Paul today. I think she's going to meet up with Paul.
Yeah,
I think she's going to meet up with Paul. We're going to have to find out a little bit more about Paul's story.
You tell you what cut it off for you.
We're done.
Okay, Green.
Oh, hey, you guys, let's do a selfie.
All right.
Before we get started. Yes, this will be so good.
Woo!
There.
Izzy. Woo. Izzy. 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 We're ready.
Hey, boys and girls, and we're back. We were ready for you. And I'm inquiring Izzy with WDIG, and we're back to dig deep and find the best foundation for our house. And we have our two builders here again.
Hey, I'm Sandy Not So Wise, and I believe that sand is still the best foundation.
And I am Roxy Wise, and I stand firm that a rock foundation is the best.
Oh, we still got some competition here. Hey, why don't we ask this man over here? He looks like a smart guy. Let's go get him. Sir, who are you?
I'm Paul, the Apostle.
Can you give us your opinion on which of these foundations would be the best, either the sand or the rock, for our house?
I think I can. Let me tell you about my story. You see, I used to be a pretty bad guy. I used to build my life on having power and destroying others. I used to be a really terrible person. I hated Christians so much that I ran around hunting them down and killing them.
I agree with you. You were a mean guy.
Shoot. Back then, I had a very shaky foundation.
Well, it sure sounds like it. What happened to change all of that?
One day when I was on the road to Damascus, there was a bright light. I couldn't see anything. It knocked me to my knees, and I was completely blind. Ooh. I heard a voice calling out to me, and it was Jesus Christ. He said to me, "Why are you persecuting me and my Christians?" I made the best decision that day in my life when I decided to follow after him. But first, I had to ask for paid off all my sins. From that day on, I built my life on the solid rock of forgiveness, a solid rock foundation.
Well, what about that?
I think I'm going to work on my foundation. Well, even, here's a rock, and you know, it says foundation of forgiveness, a solid rock foundation. What do you think about that, Sandy?
I don't know. I think I'm going to need a little bit more convincing. Let's just keep building and figure out what works the best.
All right, let's keep building.
Okay, boys and girls, you've heard this tonight. Keep digging. Tonight and be back tomorrow as we're still trying to decide what is the best foundation, the rock or sand. This is Inquiring Izzy WDIG and we're signing off. See you tomorrow.
Wow, that was good. That Paul's story is so good. I can't believe that he was forgiven. That's our word.
He was so mean.
I know, he had been so mean. And I mean, he'd even been arrested. I mean, you know, so, I mean, it's just amazing what God can do, Jesus will do.
Yes, it is.
Okay, so, and that Izzy, she's got her hands full.
I mean, she's a good reporter. Though.
She is.
Yes.
But that Sandy not so wise and Roxy the wise, I'm just not sure who's going to come out on top in that.
I'm worried about that Sandy not so wise.
I know. I don't know why. Sand, it just crumbles. Every time I make a sandcastle.
I know somebody messes it up.
Exactly. Mm. So, okay, now we're going to move into our verses for the night, and Emma Booth and Sam are going to go over our verses and our theme for the rest of the night.
Welcome back to day two of VBS. Today's story was about Paul and the foundation of forgiveness, and Emma's going to tell you about that.
Romans 5:8, for God commended his love towards us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5:8, one more time. But God commended his love towards us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5:8. Now send us a video of you saying the verse.
Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying Vacation Bible School. We're going to go over our motto and theme verse. Our motto is Jesus, our strong foundation. And our theme verse is Philippians 1:6. Being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Philippians 1:6. All right, we're going to say it one more time. Philippians 1:6. Being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Philippians 1:6. And be sure to send us a video of you saying the motto and the theme verse. Thank you.
Those verses. Do you have the verse? Can you say today's verse?
No.
Me either. Romans 5:8. But God commendeth his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. He died for all of us. Isn't that crazy how he did that? Okay, here we go. What is our week's motto?
Jesus, strength,
strong. Oh. We're going to get it. You're going to get it. I promise you'll get
it. Let me see.
Jesus,
our strong foundations.
Right. She's going to get it. You guys just keep watching this week. She is going to. Now we're going to move on to music. Sure hope this internet starts working. That's okay. It might happen anywhere, but the internet is very important for me. It's how I'm watching it. So let's move on to music.
Hey! We're recording.
Sorry, guys. We didn't see you there. We were too busy noticing that there was road work ahead.
Yeah, I sure hope it does.
Okay, she's a little crazy. Back to building our firm foundations. So today's lesson, I heard that you had a foundation of forgiveness, and the lesson was on Paul, and he was chosen by God to go tell the Gentiles about Jesus. So he got arrested, and he got taken to King Agrippa. And he was telling King Agrippa his story. Well, Paul used to not believe in Jesus, but he used to persecute Christians. And that was not a very good thing. So on his way one day, he was on the road to Damascus, and Jesus blinded him with a very bright light. And through the bright light, he heard this great voice, and he knew it was Jesus. Paul turned from his sins and started to follow Jesus, just like all of you should do. Thank you.
music. Let's go see Miss Beth and Miss Tracy at the food truck. I am ready for snacks.
I love music, but I like some snacks too. Wonder what we're gonna have today. Can't wait to see Miss Beth and Miss Tracy.
Hey guys, it's the snack ladies from White's Memorial helping to do Bible school again. Tonight's gonna be our easy night. We're gonna do something quick and easy so you'll be ready to just get right on into Bible school.
All you need is a little glass bowl, some cheese doodles,
or balls, or whichever ones.
Yeah.
Put them in your little cup.
They're cold.
And snack away.
Bulldozer crafts, here we come.
No, I feel like I need to keep this tape with me. My crafts don't always do right. But that's okay, because Miss Karen and Miss Nancy are going to show you how to do your craft today, and it's a forgiveness tag.
All right.
And it can go on your book bag when you guys get to go to school, but you have to pay attention so you can put it together correctly. So we'll see how those turn out soon. Okay, today is number two, I'm sorry, and it's foundation of forgiveness. And we're gonna make these cute little key ring bracelet. It says forgiven. Okay, and the Bible story is about Paul's redemption, Acts 26, 1, 20 through 29. And the point is Jesus loves me regardless of my sins. And Miss Nancy's gonna show you how to start doing your bracelet.
You pull your cord together and loop it around your keychain, like this, and then you just add the little, you line them up on the things.
You'll run one accordion one way and run the other accordion the other side, and then you'll pull it. And she'll show you right here in a minute.
Put them on like this, and then you're right in. You're going to have forgiveness. You've got all the little beads here to go on there. If I can get them on there.
And when you get to the cross part, it says to run one end through and the other end through. Well, it's really hard. We had a struggle with that. So the best thing is just run one end through and then tie it on the back and tie a knot.
Anyway, you just lace these through here. And like Karen said, put the cross, you know, put the cross on the end of it. And this will be your final product when you get through.
Let's get on to the wrecking ball recreation time.
Wrecking ball. We're going to go play some games. Let's go. Let's go. Game time. Okay, guys. Welcome to night two of VBS. And we're here at our house tonight, just like you guys are at home at your house. And we're going to play game time. Wrecking ball game time. That's what this is called. This is my husband, Jeff, and he is going to try to beat me. First of all, you got a bucket that had all your stuff in it, and there's a ball. Okay, these are the ones we had at our house, so you can add more. If you have another bucket, you have more balls, you can practice. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your ball, and you're gonna try to toss it into your bucket. Now you go, Jeff. Oh, it's okay, honey. Maybe next time. Then, what we're gonna do is, come on, we're gonna step back a little bit further. He doesn't like to lose.
Lady's on video. We're going to step back a little bit farther. And we're going to think of... I'm going to try again. You want to go first this time? Oh, no. Oh, look at you. Oh, good job, Jim. That was not nice. Okay, guys. So here's what I want you to do. Get your family to play. Remember, you can't play this with a hard ball inside the house in the bucket. You have to play outside so you can not break anything. Get your parents to play. See you next time. Hey, guys. I hope you had a good time at game time. You cleaned everything up. In your packet, in your bucket, was your little packet, today's stuff. I hope you filled out your questions and went over everything. And there's some cool little games in here. I hope that you worked on that today and you'll be ready to come back for tomorrow night for Bible school and see what happens on day 3. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Jesus, happy playing Bible school. We be aware, Jesus and I. Amen.
Amen.